Este é o nosso triste fado, que vamos andando e do pobre coitado. Velha canção é que a culpa é do Estado, por ser o espelho do reinado. A história, por mais do que uma vez, foi mais cruel que a do Pedro.
I noticed big differences in, for instance, in some behavior, for instance, in traffic. In Faro, my first experience with the car, it was like I was standing on the zebra and the car stopped, and I stopped, and I was like...
You didn't know what to do.
I didn't know what to do, and the guy was like, come on. Yes. So I crossed the street. Yeah, I just know that the economy of Serbia and Portugal is similar. That people live similar, and the Portuguese people don't give a damn about that so much as my people do, and I think that's beautiful.
You're gonna find your piece in the puzzle.
It seems so easy to encourage people to be active because people there, they spend more time sleeping in their own little desk, in their own environment, and they build their walls sometimes. Like, oh, that's my little world and I don't want to, it's not, the rest is not mine and I don't care. So the internet helps them to be involved.
I am speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street.
When you look at people, can you say that he is not Portuguese?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So could you guess our nationality?
Sorry, este cara de inglês, pá.
Inglês.
India.
Ele aqui é para esse português, já tomou.
Gotcha.
Ah, é certo, é certo.
I look at her and I can tell. Where are you from?
Germany.
You
Germany.
Can tell, yeah.
Portuguese youngsters, do you think they are active? Wanting to make a better world?
They want to make a better world. I know that. They are lazy. I know that as well. I think it's not hard to be lazy when you have ocean and all this atmosphere. I got lazy as well, you know, I'm like, I just want to, you know, I just want to drink this and go somewhere and yeah. Sit and, you know, ah, let's wait for the sunset, really.
Temos fuga ou fisco, estradas de alto risco. Temos valiosos costumes e tradições que eu não percebo se nos maldizemos. Quais as razões? Temos chicos perto, burlas e protestos. Temos tantos motivos para sorrir que eu nem imagino qual será a desculpa que vem a seguir. Gosto tanto deste país, só não entendo o que o faz feliz. Se a rir da miséria de outros quando a vemos, ou chorar da nossa própria quando a temos. Gosto tanto deste país, só não entendo quando ele se diz senhor do futuro, maturo, duro, mas seguro. E eu juro que ainda não o vi.
A poucas horas do início da 29ª concentração de motas em Faro, os preparativos ultimam-se, os motares começam a chegar.
The capital of the most touristic region in Portugal. But do you feel the presence of
tourists here? No, just one or two times a year. People from other countries who come here, like in the meeting motorcycles, they come, they stay here for 1 week or 2 weeks, and then they go again.
Faro is not the mainstream tourism place in Algarve.
We could learn from them, but unfortunately people just don't stay here in Faro long enough to teach us something about them. There are coming many people from Portugal, to Portugal from Eastern Europe, so I believe that plus the immigrants from South America, we have about 25-30%.
50%?
Yeah.
40? No, 40... 30%
About 20%. I think we have to employ the Portuguese people, obviously. Because
no, the Portuguese don't want to work so with so less money, I think.
People who came from Africa and South America was the one who built was building places to live and the streets and all of that, because the Portuguese just want to be doctors and engineers.
Sunny guys?
What? Kind and lazy.
This is really difficult for me because I'm very proud of who I am. I'm very proud of being Portuguese, but when I look to the other persons around me, they just talk bad about this country. It's never okay, but they just don't give a damn. They just don't do nothing to overpass it. So I believe they just are poor-minded persons.
But they're friendly in general.
I had the opportunity to meet some really nice, beautiful Portuguese people that know that I can rely on someone. And if you ask me why, I don't know. I just feel it.
Did you felt welcome here? Did you find any discrimination, prejudice? Yes?
Well, people call me terrorist sometimes.
Gosto tanto deste país, só não entendo quando ele se diz Senhor de um futuro maduro, duro, mas seguro, eu juro que ainda não o vi.
Enjoying the experience?
Not always, but since last year it's a lot better and it's nice now. I can deal with things much better than before because it's very different to my home country. Everything is well organized, working, you know, everything is normal, at least in my eyes. And here everything is chaos, anarchy, corruption, ignorance, but the sun is shining and the weather is nice, the sea is nice, and life is much easier. It's less stressful, the food is good, you get to overlook the things that are different, I mean that are horribly different from home, and you get to appreciate the things that are also very much in a positive way different from home.
I found the people less open-minded than I would have expected it.
At the society, the youngsters, I would expect it to be much more dynamic, and here they kind of satisfy with their situation, staying in cafes, having conversations and stuff, but much more in a lazy way. So it's like, well, this is a very slow-paced society. People are now really pushy.
Close mind?
stubborn.
Stubborn?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's difficult to divide the Greek culture with the Cypriot culture, okay, because it's kind of common. The language is common, and we share, like, even our hymn is like
the hymn is the same. There's a part, 40%, they are speaking other language, they have the coin, they have the flag, they have the schools, other habits. No. They are like a little part of Turkey.
Oh. Yeah, it's the best way to say it.
Yeah.
It's an occupied part, it's not Cyprus. Cyprus. Just know that before 6 years, we could not even go there. And there came the time that everybody migrated, and then they closed it. So
they couldn't come, and you couldn't go.
Yeah.
But then they opened 6 years ago.
6 years ago, they opened just for visa. But even now, don't think that it's coming and going. So yeah, once we cross the border, then you see another country, different mentality.
Yeah.
You should be a bit sensitive in that. For example, not to mention
Turkish part.
The Turkish, to the Turkish, of course you say Turkish,
yes,
part.
Yes, for you it's not good to say that.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is recording.
Yes.
Whoa!
If you'd say that if we were going to be a Greek island, by now we would be destroyed. Because all the Greek islands are forgotten by everyone.
You're not a Greek island, that's it. You're much more than that. Of course, you're a country, you have identity, you have a nationality.
Nationality is Greek.
Is Greek not Cypriot?
No, it's Greek. Greeks are the ones who were from the same race.
There is only one race, I believe, the human.
Yes, no? I agree with you.
Experience participation, intercultural communication these days, and as we know, the most important is how we react to this. Suspicion?
I mean, I'm not 100% sure, but most probably he did it.
He doesn't speak Turkish, they're just looking at me.
But he's have to show respect to his culture, and he grown up in a...
Come on, Maria!
was like that?
I don't know. Maybe half a million?
The percentage.
Oh, percentage. Okay, 1 or 2%, I would say.
Do you think that they could, they bring a good impact to Turkish society?
Some of them do, some of them don't.
If you had to find a word to define the Turkish people, what would it be?
Unique?
Since this is a city dividing Asia and Europe, do you feel European?
I don't think the city is dividing Asia and Europe, but I think it's more like a bridge between Europe and Asia. So I have been living in, on the European side, since I was born, but that doesn't necessarily make me European or Asian. I think this is a city that brings the both continents together.
We don't really like consider people born in Turkey or Istanbul, or even in the west part, like the far west part of Turkey, we don't consider people like European or Anatolian. In Turkey we have the difference, like the western and the, eastern, let's say. This western are the white Turks. This the Turks. And the Easterns are the ones Kurdish people, Arabic people, and so like in almost everywhere.
Some women, they have to get married because their parents don't want them to. But also the opposite, you can still find them. It really depends.
On the family?
On the family, on the cultural background, the roots, even on in the area. Istanbul is like a bubble, maybe.
And how do the conservative women or families look at girls like us, like modern, let's say?
In my opinion, there is not like any clash between these two groups. They just somehow tolerate each other. She's this way and she's this way.
So before coming or before getting to know better Turkey, you had an idea of a more oriental country.
Yeah.
And now that you are here, you find it very close to Europe?
No, it's not Europe 100%, that's for sure. I would say that there are some levels of Turkey. In the more rural areas of Turkey, interpetual in their own way. And still there are things in Turkey that, for me, as now somebody who is now living in Europe, they are unacceptable. There is a group of people who is living this European life, and there is a lot of people who are living still like their traditional Muslim life. For me, they are not interacting a lot. They are somehow living in their own world. I don't have a friend, the girl wearing headscarves, because they are just living in their own environment. They are just having, they have friends among them. And I also noticed it about my Turkish friends, that they are just sticking to each other. So
they're not interacting.
They are not interacting.
Consider are the main problems that youngsters are facing in this country?
It's the problem of the visa and the borders, but for me, as I noticed, the biggest problem of the youngsters here is the relation with the family. Usually, they are really dependent on the parents. They don't want them to get involved in social movements, in any kind of youth activities, because they consider it as a kind of dangerous.
A 2-minute theater show. On how was this training course for you?
And I have some movie for you, and I will show you.
Okay, have a look.
What's going on here?
I mean, the group was, in my opinion, like, the group really connected and attached to. So it was great.
Yes, yes.
And I have some new friends now, and, you know, I enjoyed it.
Yes, I learned more about Turkish culture.
Are you ready?
Stworzono je koza zeby gruski czasła. Koza nie chce grusku czusać, gruski nie chcą spodać. Stworzono je pies zeby koza kusą. A pies nie chce kozy kusać, koza nie chce grusku czusać, gruski nie spodają. A po to je ki zeby piesa walu. A ki nie chce piesa balić, a pies nie chce kozy kusać, koza nie chce.
Now let's stay here. Thank you very much and bye.
I like the culture. I like their way of behaving. I can say that I prefer them to the Portuguese, people. But it's just some different. It's something that I can adapt, and I am adapting well. Yeah, maybe they are more serious, and they are not as open to show the feelings. Yeah, to show their emotions. They don't do it. They don't do it as much.
I don't know.
You've been here before on holidays, but what did you know about this country before coming here? And did it match your expectations now that you are living here, really living?
Yeah, I had really big expectations about the country. Maybe you had some prejudice.
What kind of prejudice did you have?
Prejudice for the people, very Catholic, not open-minded. But after I found people have a good fun to laugh about themselves. They're quite open to each other. Mm-hmm. If people can trust in you, they're absolutely very open, like Latinos.
It would be alcoholism. Alcoholism is a problem that is more evident in the older generations, but it starts in younger generations. And there's the deep belief that a Polish person, especially young man, has to drink. Everybody in Poland has to drink, especially if they are males. It's connected to the culture of the man. If you want to be a man, you have to drink. Of course, I'm making some kind of exaggeration here. I would say, oh, no, I don't drink. And they would say, okay, but do you have any problem of health or something? Then, generally, they lack perspective. Their perspective is not inside their country, it's outside.
Lack of perspective inside the country?
Yeah, inside.
So they are very anxious to go abroad?
Yeah, especially to England or United States, where they can make money. They don't believe in
economic possibilities of Poland, and it has. In my opinion, it has lots of economic possibilities. Of course, it's a country in transition still.
Traditional people.
Traditional.
Yes, Polak can do it.
They're not so like friendly, open like people on the west. Maybe because, you know, we are like because of the system of this in the past. Like, we have here the Hitler, then we have the Russian, the communism, and.
About themselves like suffering. The countries bring and take the cross and the price. Because every time the other countries invade Poland, so they have every time they have defense themselves. And I think for this, they feel themselves like someone have to defense from others. Mm. And others, in this case, are also other religions, this kind of stuff. Why you consider foreigners somebody grew up in your nation, was born in your nation, just from another religion?
One of the natural enemies of the communist regime was the church. This regime was put out. Who shows up as a natural winner? The church and all the religion itself.
Religion is very present in
everywhere. In the schools, for example, there are pictures of John Paul II everywhere. There are crosses in the classroom, in the parliament. They have a cross in the parliament.
More the older people, like, you know, they don't tolerate other religion.
I don't think so.
No? Why?
Why? Because we are hard Catholic, I think. Go to church, we believe in God and only our God.
You gotta keep a positive mind, 'cause you got a positive soul. A positive mind, 'cause you got a positive soul. You gotta keep a positive mind, 'cause you got a positive soul.
mosque, and it's basically paganism, or it's a belief of nature, and we don't have any book where we have all the rules written. We don't have like building or church. We just have some ways of life. It's actually a way of life. So like everything has a spirit. The trees have a spirit. The rock has a spirit if it has any special margins on it. And the spirits can be kind or can be evil. Obviously, it depends what you do to them. And then also the one big part of this belief, I really like it, is your life has to be cool and calm and enjoyable. So enjoyment is a big part of our life, actually. So you go to a sauna, you have a nice night, you drink some beer, you have some good food, you work obviously as well, but it's still, you have to enjoy it. And this is like the general national religion in Estonia. Like it grew with the nation and with the language and traditions. And they also say that if you are born Estonian and if you speak Estonian language and you follow some traditions, you are already a member of this religion.
Second World War, which they won in their opinion, it was good for Estonians, but I think that 20 or 30,000 Estonians were taken to Siberia, and basically half of them never came back. That's why the political conflict is so big, because Estonians can still remember what Russians did to them parents or grandparents or something like that.
I think that disintegration is a very sensitive subject still, mainly because they think that it's not, but they have still the hard feelings with each other, and they still have the jokes and the stereotypes. Russian is not official as an official language, but they have everything. They have the newspaper, they have an edition in Russian, an edition in Estonia, and it sells side by side. But they don't recognize after this Russian language as and even after for the job they need to know Estonian. I mean, most of the jobs that they require Estonian language.
No, it's different, 100% different.
Russian background persons want, then they have equal opportunities, or even they are better because they have English and Estonian and Russian language, but Estonians, young Estonians don't speak Russian.
Because Estonia people, they know English better, and Estonians are more European than Russian.
Two sides of that, because some Estonians are very like conservative, and they only like Estonians, but on the other side, the people who can speak fluently Estonia and Russia, they have much more job opportunities.
Yes, it's more easy to speak with those people who speak the same language with you.
Do you speak Russian?
No,
only Estonian.
Very little.
But you were born here or in Russia?
Yes, I was born here. I'm Russian, but I was born here.
So you are Estonian?
I'm more in Estonian.
So you're a good example of integration between the both.
You can't do it in one action or activity. It's a matter of time.
But maybe when you motivate people to be together and then to talk, they find things in common, then they can find that they have much more similarities than differences.
Communicating consists of talking, which we do all the time, and listening, which we do not. So listen up and spread the joy.
Today, a lot of positive energy, creativity, and I would say.
Different backgrounds, different ages.
Communication with different peoples, and all around the world.
We should share our message. We should be active.
New faces, meeting new people.
I like this, all around the world.
Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid.
If you can imagine it, you can do it.
The power to change something.
You can be active through new technology.
Using media tools, things that might be really simple, you know.
We think about some things in a different way.
Of how powerful it can be.
Observing and taking something from each other. So, in this meeting, it's really like...
How is it?
We all like human beings and we just have to come together and it feels like we are the group, we are the family.
Yes, lovely.
We are going to be representing our world in the future, so we should teach them as well. If it's possible, not only youth should be involved in this, but also...
Be active, change the world.